Series 3, what are we most excited about? I suppose the continuation of the sort of historical background of the continuation of Series 1, Series 2. We're now coming up to the ceasefire. The ceasefire has been announced. So many things, so many exciting things happen after that. See how the girls and the family and the community react.
And the nun.
And the nun. React to all the exciting and historically groundbreaking events that happen subsequently. I'm looking forward to that anyway.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, me too. I don't know. You said it all, really. And I think just seeing more sides to the characters and development with everything, just, I think in general it's just going to be really exciting to see season three and to shoot it.
People have really fallen in love with these characters. I'm curious what it is that you love most about them, why you think that people have responded to them and latched on to these girls in such a passionate way.
Well, I think they're very true. I think everything at that age, like for the teenage characters especially, everything's super heightened. So they're very true to how they feel all the time. The emotions are all on the surface. And I think the fact that Lisa didn't compromise them and try and make, often with female characters, they try to soften them down a bit or they try and make them a bit more understandable. But Jamie Lee O'Donnell, who plays Michelle, they talked about her character at one point and said, you know, should we make her a bit more understandable? And Lisa went, no, f*** that. Sorry, I don't know if I can swear or not.
You can and you did.
Okay, I'm sorry. But it's also like, just like, don't, you know, they're just very true. And like, I think from the first episode of series one, people went, oh, I'm not sure about this. But then by the end of series one, people love them. So it's really special. I think we've grown to love them. They feel like another group of friends that we have, if that makes sense, if it doesn't sound too weird.
Literally, as the series has gone along, they've been growing up. I'm curious, do you think in season three, are we going to see any changes in the characters? Are they going to be essentially the same people we've come to know and love over the first two series?
They're still going to be dicks. Yeah, Lisa calls them a group of dicks, so I don't think so. What do you think?
Why mess with perfection?
The thing that I suppose surprised me most is I thought this would be quite a niche show. You know, I thought some people would like it, but I think this the sort of the audience figures we caught and sort of just sort mind blowing for all of us. We really weren't expecting that. I love being able to show a side of Northern Ireland that hasn't been seen before. I love telling female centered stories. So that for me is the big thing about being able to do more of this, and I'm really excited to continue their stories.
I think obviously for season three we're talking about a very transformative point in the history for Ireland. I'm curious if that's going to be matched by a transformation in the characters, or if they're going to be the same lovely bag of dicks we've always come to know and love.
I think when you have a backdrop like Northern Ireland in the 90s, there was nothing secure about it. It was always changing, even with the beginnings of the peace process. You know, we didn't know it was going to work. There was a lot of nervousness surrounding it, and it seemed to fall down a lot. So I think one thing I want to do is keep the gang, the sort of steady heart of the show that people can rely on. And so essentially, they'll go off on their various journeys, but they'll come back together and they'll be the same, you know, because I think audiences take great comfort in that as well, you know.
Audiences have absolutely fallen in love with this group of girls. Can you talk a little bit about what you love about them and what it was when you first read Lisa's writing that spoke to you the most?
I think the fact that they are portrayed to just really be who they are. They're sort of clumsily finding, especially with Erin, she's sort of clumsily finding her way through life. And they are, as you said, a bag of dicks. And I think that's something to be celebrated, that young women are like this when they're growing up. And every one of them is so unique and so well-rounded and well put together through Lisa's writing that it's just joyous to be able to play it.
So often when we see female coming-of-age narratives on screen, it's somehow sanitised or romanticised. Is the visceral comedic quality of Lisa's writing, I think, do you think that's important? Do you think that matters, that kind of, to have that kind of raw depiction on screen?
Yeah, I totally do. And I feel like none of us are really sexualised and we're all quite pure. And I think that's great, especially for like a teenage, you know, centred show. And it's great that we don't censor ourselves and there's a real freeness with all of us. And it's just, it's brilliant, and it's great to be able to play them, and it's great that those characters are on screen.
Do curious, obviously fans, when they meet you, must tell you their favourite moments from the first couple of series. I'm curious if there's a particular episode, a particular moment for each of your characters that really you enjoy the most, either because of your experience making it or just the end result was just something you were proud of.
Yeah, I mean, definitely the final episode of the first series with Orla doing the talent show was definitely a special moment for me and all of us, because it was towards the very last couple of days of filming, and that was a very special day to film, and it turned out so beautifully that we even made ourselves cry. I mean, I'm sure even Lisa was crying. It's very conceited, but it's true, and that shows how the show stands.
Yeah, sort of for all of us, or as a character, probably the last scene in the last episode as well. I feel like there was such a build-up to that, and imagining how that was going to be cut together. But for the four of us, watching Louisa up doing the dance as Orla was something really special, because we've all invested in those characters so much, and we'd be seeing her practicing the routine for weeks, and it was just a special moment to actually watch her do it.
I think obviously watching the end result on screen is hilarious with all of you guys. I'm curious what the atmosphere is like on set, and if it's hard to get through some of these takes with the material you guys have to work with.
It is. Yeah, it's a nightmare. It's a nightmare. I definitely say that Tommy Tiernan's the worst. Yeah. I think that we were a lot better last year, but now we realise that you can corpse a wee bit more. If Tommy's doing it, we're allowed to do it. But no, it's a real struggle. It's a real struggle. And even it was a different experience reading the season 2 scripts this time round and imagining how the rest of the guys were going to deliver those lines already. It was funny.
Do you have a message to fans of the series who've loved and supported it and can't wait for hopefully many more series to come?
Just thank you for watching and for sticking with us. And yeah, we're incredibly grateful. So thanks.